To session two of stacks under data structures and applications. So let me just go to the PPT and resume the discussion on stack. Now in the previous session we have seen the fundamental concepts behind stack, that is LIFO, last in, first out. Last inserted item can be obtained first. So we have seen two operations pertaining to that, push and pop. Now we will use these operations for some applications. Now before we actually go for the specific application or applications, let me just give you some preamble for these notations. The infix, prefix, and postfix. You can see here. The infix really means that the operator is in between the operands, like 2 plus 3. Plus is the operator, operands are 2 and 3. Now we call this a traditional way of writing any expression. Whereas prefix, the operator appears before the operands, plus 2, 3. The postfix, on the other hand, the operator appears after the operand. That's why it's called postfix. So, for instance, you can see here that all these are valid infix expressions, whether it involves with the variables like A and B, or whether it involves with, you know, the constants like numeric values 2 and 3, or it might even have some kind of brackets here, parentheses. So you can call this a parenthesis expression. But in all this, you can see here that the operator is fixed in between the operands. So you can see here the operator appears in between the operands. On the other hand, postfix, you can see here the operator appears after the operands, AB plus or 2, 3 plus. You can see here this expression, actually the postfix expression has the built-in ability of the precedence of this evaluation of the operation. For instance, 4 into 7. So this is done first because the operator appears first in the order, and the result of this will be used as an operand, like 7 into 4, 28. Now 3 plus 28, so 31 will be the answer. So this is the operand, this is another operand, so plus will be the postfix operator. So this is another way of writing the expression where the operator appears on the end, that means after the operands. Prefix, on the other hand, you have the operator prior to the operand. So plus AB or plus 2, 3. You can see here star 4, 7. So this is done first, and then plus 3, whatever the result of this is, 28. Now, we may need to convert this one particular type of expression into another. The reason is that traditionally we use infix. See, we are not using postfix and prefix while we write the expressions. Traditionally, we have been taught like that. But when it comes to evaluation of the expressions by the compilers or by the machine, you will see that postfix is actually easier and faster compared to infix. So probably it's easy for us to write, a human programmer or anybody who writes infix is easier compared to postfix, but expression evaluation is easy for the machine in terms of the postfix. So in order to make it compatible, I write in infix, let somebody convert this into postfix, some algorithm, let it convert to postfix, and the evaluation also can be done by appropriate algorithm. So it is immaterial. But for me, writing infix is most easiest form, but the machine can translate it or convert this into postfix and evaluate. So evaluation in any particular form requires prior conversions. So how to convert, for instance, infix to postfix? So let's assume that this is my, you know, expression, infix expression. So in terms of the bracket, that means the precedence, we know that brackets or the parentheses takes the highest. So I can just do that first, like A plus B is done first. I'll go with left to right evaluation. So A, B plus, so that's what is shaded here. Similarly, this parenthesis, of course, star I will retain as it is, and CD minus, so that's the postfix for this. So what happens is I can just convert this into this, convert this into this, and retain all the other operators and the operands as it is. Then what happens? I can see here that which operator has the highest precedence. So this becomes one temporary, you know, symbol, I can call it. This I can call it as another temporary symbol, and so on. So for instance, I can call this as X, and this I can call it as Y. And similarly, dollar E star F, etc. So here we know that star, you know, dollar, I'm just using it for exponentiation, you know, exponential kind of thing. So in this case, depending upon the precedence of the operator, I can just do that first. For instance, here, star is lower precedence compared to dollar, so I can just do this dollar first. That means that postfix, so this is my operator, which are the operands for this. So this is infix. So this is my first operand, Y. This is my second operand, E. So CD minus E, that will be my operands, followed by the operator, which is dollar. So this becomes my converted operand. Next, what happens? I'll retain the rest of the things as it is. So I can call this now as X. This call it as Y. Now we have star and star. Both are same precedence. So I'll go with left to right. So this is my first operand X. This is my second operand Y, followed by star. So you can see here X is nothing but AB plus, and Y is nothing but CD minus E dollar. You can see here. And star will be the operator. And this is my X now. And I have now left with only two operands and one operator. So X, F and star. What is X? AB plus CD minus E dollar. Star will be my, is my X, and F is my second operand. You can see here, and star is my, the last operator. So now we have successfully converted the infix expression to postfix. So my advice to the beginners is not directly jumping from here to here, but go through these intermittent steps. That means one by one, as per the precedence. So the brackets or the parentheses first, and then the dollar, that means exponentiation, then star or division, then your plus or minus, because star and division, multiplication and division has the same precedence. So it can be left to right, and plus and minus, again, the same thing, same precedence. You can go from left to right. Okay. So similarly, postfix to infix, we can convert in the same way. Like always, the operator appears after the operand. So I can just, you know, pick this first as it is shaded here. So convert this postfix into prefix. It's done. And this is my operand, first operand. Second operand is C, it's retained minus. So XC minus is nothing but X minus C. So what is X? A plus B. So A plus B minus C. So either you can put a bracket or without a bracket, because plus and minus has the same precedence, it will be done from left to right. So conversion, if you follow step by step, it becomes easier. Okay, now, as I said earlier, converting into postfix of any given infix expression is done mainly for the fact that postfix evaluation is faster than infix. Why? Because, for instance, you can take the same example here. Let's assume an infix expression, something like this. So if at all the compiler wants to evaluate this, it has to start from here to here, because after all, this is a string. So this goes from left to right. And the unfortunate thing here is that we do not know the highest precedence where it appears. It might appear at the end. So unless you go through the entire string, you know, you will not know which is the highest precedence. Or you may not get that highest precedence. Highest precedence may appear here itself, in the beginning itself. So scanning through this as a complete string, assuming that's a big expression, will take time. So probably you have to first time scan the entire, you know, string or expression and try to find out where is this highest precedence operator appears, and then come back again and, you know, keep doing this. So this type of toggling between scanning of the expression first to last and then coming back again first to last, all these things would take more time. So we have a very, very easiest method is to convert this into postfix, and one scan of postfix, we can easily convert them. Sorry, you can easily evaluate it. So that's the reason why we try to convert from infix to suffix. Let's not worry about the algorithm for converting infix to suffix that follows this. So first we shall concentrate on assuming that the input is a postfix expression. Okay, now let's assume that the given expression is a valid postfix expression, and how do we actually convert it into, sorry, how do we evaluate that? So conversion comes later. We need to know how to convert, assuming that we are given a postfix expression already. So let me take the simplest example here, like, you know, AB, C star plus. So I'm sorry, so I just delete this. Okay, so what happens here? This is equivalent to the infix expression. Okay, I'll just put plus here. A plus B star C. So this is my original infix. So BC star is first, because star has got higher precedence than plus. So BC star, and then A, this is the second operand. So A plus BC star. That means the conversion from infix to suffix is done by some algorithm. Let's see that later. So this is my input, you know, the postfix expression. Now, how am I going to evaluate this expression? So instead of considering this as variables, let me just take this. This is for just example I've given, because it's an evaluation. We assume some values for ABC. So let me just assume that A has value 3, B has value 4, and C has value 5, and we have the star and plus. So 4 into 5, 20, 20 plus 3, or 3 plus 20 is 23. So 23 is my evaluated value, I mean final result. So how to build an algorithm in order to evaluate this postfix? We know that the precedence of operators in postfix is built into the expression itself. That means the same order. So whenever we get the, you know, the operators, like star first in this case, that means it's the highest precedence. So in order to evaluate this, this knowledge can be very easily used to evaluate. So what we do is we scan the expression, the postfix expression, This is my input. So we scan the postfix expression starting with the first character. Now, whenever this is an operand, what we do is we'll push it into the stack. And whenever it is an operator, we just pop twice because it's a binary operator. So we pop twice and evaluate that depending upon the operator and then push it back. So this process is continued until we reach the end of the string or the postfix expression. So this is the simplest one how the stack could be used, because we need to retain these values or the operands in the stack such that the last inserted one we require for the operation to be completed. For example, this is an operand, first one, 3, 4 is an operand, push it again, like we did pushing of 3, and again push 5 because it's an operand, right? And now there is an operator star, so I can just pop twice, that is 5 and 4, so it's popped. Perform this operation, which is 20, push it back. So it is last inserted. So that means I am getting this temporary calculation or the sub expression calculation again in the stack. So now I get two operands, 3 and 20, right, in the stack. So when I go to the next symbol, that means your plus, so I can again pop twice, which is 20 and 3, and perform this. This is plus, so I get 23 and push it back into the stack. So this is gone, 23. And once I reach the end of the string, pop once because my result is already there, 23. This is the expected result. So it's very, very easy. So last inserted one I need first in order to perform this evaluation. And I can retain that value again, keeping that in the top of the stack and keep going until I reach the end of the string. So that's exactly what I have done and I got the result. So the algorithm can be built very easily, that whenever it is an operand, push it into the stack, and whenever it is an operator, pop twice and perform the operation and push it back again. Continue this until, so repetition is required, or a looping construct is required in order to start from the beginning to the end. Every time reading the symbol, noting down whether it is an operator or operand, and do push or pop. So that's exactly what it's shown here. So stack is initialized to -1. Position is to, it's an index to go through the string from beginning to the end. So as long as it's not equal to the end of the string or the length of the string, assuming that n is the length, you get the first character, that means first symbol. Let's say, let us assume that this is C, and if C is one of these, which means it's an operand, then you can push it. Because we know that push requires stack and top pointer, stack pointer, and the character to be pushed. So if it is an operand, I'm pushing. Now supposing if it's not an operand, else class is executed. So you can see here that you need to pop twice. Okay, now you can see here it's popped twice, and we need the symbol depending upon which symbol it is. This character, I'm just using it for getting one particular symbol. So depending upon this symbol, I need to perform the operation after popping twice. So this is first pop, so the first operand. The second pop is the second operand. Do the required operation. Okay, so this statement will give me an appropriate operator depending upon what operator have been encountered during the scanning of this expression, that means C. So if C belongs to plus, so I'll just do the operation plus here, so this will become plus. If it is minus, so I'll do minus, right? Now if this is multiplication, that is star, I'll do star, etc. So I can do all of this, I'm sorry, one of these operations depending upon what kind of operator you have got. Now after this sub expression evaluation is done, push it back, that's what we did. Now go to the next character and go back to the while loop. So it will again read that character, the next character actually, check whether it's an operand or operator. So if it's an operand, push it into the stack. If it's an operator, again pop twice and perform the operation and push it back into the stack. So this process is repeated until you reach the end of the string, that means length of the string. Now once you finish this, your result is already available in the stack. So one pop will give me the result. So that's what I showed here, one pop, because the result is again pushed back into the stack. So one pop will give me the result and you can return that result to the main function. So this algorithm evaluates the given postfix expression, assuming that the expression is valid and also it has the numeric, you know, numbers. And also another assumption is that it is a binary operation. So the working of this is shown here, as I've already explained. So 3 plus 4 star 5, this is my infix. So now this is converted into postfix, as I've already explained. And this is the incoming symbol. And what is the stack contents? So this is the top of the stack. And this is the, sorry, this is the bottom of the stack. And this is the top of the stack. So this will be my stack point or top. Right? So stack grows like this. Right. So now 3 is an operand, push it. 4 is an operand, push it. 5 is an operand, push into the stack. So top of the stack is 5. Star is an operator, so pop twice, 4 and 5. Perform this because star 20 is pushed back into the stack. Because once this is gone, so the result will go into the top. So top will point to this. And again, it's an operator, so perform this, pop twice, of course. 3 plus 20, 23. So it's done. And you know, pop once, you'll get back your result. Okay, now we have assumed here that infix is converted into postfix by somebody. Now, who is that somebody? So we need an algorithm in order to convert this infix expression into postfix. Now, that's exactly what we are going to study. So for this, we need what is known as a precedence table. What is this precedence table? Now remember, in order to convert the infix to suffix, as I've already explained, the highest precedence, even if you take this example, you can see here that the star comes later than plus. So I cannot simply say that 3, 4 plus now. That's wrong, because 4 into 5 has to be done first. Or this star might appear somewhere here. Assume there's a big expression. Now I may have only the lower precedence ones here in the beginning. So it all amounts to that we cannot come to a conclusion that the higher precedence one will be available soon in the expression. We don't know when it appears. So stack is used in order to preserve these kinds of things, so that we can identify the type of precedence here, so that we can either retain this in the stack or otherwise send it to the output directly. So in order to make a judgment, we need the help of some knowledge table. So I can call this as a table, which actually the table which helps us in order to find these things are available in the form of what is known as first the symbols, and then what is called as incoming precedence and incoming stack precedence. I'll just put things very easily here, because you need to understand the difference between the incoming precedence and the stack precedence. So both are incoming, you know, kind of thing. But anyway, here, incoming precedence, the first, this set of numbers indicate that the precedence of the symbols coming from the expression. Now this one, on the other hand, is the stack precedence. That means the symbols which are the characters are already stored in the stack, their precedence. Okay, so we have here the incoming symbol. Each kind of symbol has its own precedence depending upon whether it is an incoming precedence or a stack precedence. Why we should have two types of values, not just one? We will, you know, explain this when we go through the algorithm. Method is very, very easier to understand, provided we understand the concept behind these precedences. So let's assume that the incoming symbols are plus or minus because it has at the same precedence level. So the incoming precedence, I'll keep it as one, which is less than this. So the designing of this table is that the incoming precedence is kept lower than this. And not only that, both are kept lower than star and division, because star and division has got a higher precedence than this. So depending upon these values, the algorithm is built. Okay. So star and slash, it has got 3 and 4. Between these two, this is lesser than the stack precedence. It's deliberately written in order to pop the stack contents in order to frame your postfix. Okay, I think once we take up some example, you'll understand. So similarly, you know, dollar or caret symbol, which is used for exponentiation, again, it has got a higher precedence than this. So you can see here, these values are higher than this, but the, you know, the values where stack and this is reversed. It's not like this is less than this compared to your star and plus. Why? Because this caret and this one, you know, the evaluation is done from right to left rather than left to right for these symbols. So it's not same as plus, minus, star and slash. So it's from right to left. So that's why it is 6 and 5. For all operands A to Z, we assume that the infix expression has only these symbols A to Z. The precedence, incoming precedence, is kept as the highest of all this. You can see 8, and there is no precedence attached in the stack precedence table. That is this one, this column. Why? Because we do not store any symbols or operands in the stack. We send them directly to the output expression. So they never appear in the stack. So there is no need to attach any precedence. Next, we also can have parentheses, because it's a parenthesis expressions which we may have to convert. So left parenthesis, you have 7, which is less than this, you know, the operands, but greater than all of them. And so we force them to store in the stack, and this is 0 when it is in the stack. The reason is we forcibly take it out. I'll tell you why this is done. And closing parenthesis, you can see that incoming, it's the lowest, and there is no set, because we don't store right parenthesis also. Why? Because once we encounter the right parenthesis, we simply pop all contents until we reach left parenthesis and convert them, put them in the output. So for example, if I have open parenthesis A plus B, right? So this is the simplest example I can give. So the moment I encounter, I may have so many symbols before this, assume. So this may be the first left parenthesis, this may be the right parenthesis. Okay, now when I encounter this, assuming that the infix expression given as an input is always valid, the most recent left parenthesis is the one for the matching one for this. So what I can do is, the moment I get right parenthesis, I don't need to store it in the stack. I simply go and pick the items from the stack until I encounter the left parenthesis and simply put it in the output. So there is no need to store this. Similarly, even if you have a parenthesis within a parenthesis, I mean nested kind of thing, then also it's possible. For example, I may have, you know, C here plus, so this is left parenthesis, A, right? Okay, I put a left parenthesis here and star B, I may have this way. I may have any number of symbols here, and the moment I reach the right parenthesis here, I don't need to worry about that right parenthesis. I simply, okay, I'll just modify this, because once we go to the example, you'll see that we will attach extra left and the extra right parenthesis. So let me not confuse you now. So we will take a valid infix expression. So that time probably you will be able to understand this better. So for the moment, left parenthesis, once it is encountered, it is forced into the stack to be stored. And once you encounter the right parenthesis, we actually pop and then, you know, put it in the output expression until we get the left parenthesis. So the precedence values are attached to this in such a way that, we can force all these things to happen. That's the idea. Okay, so now let us see the algorithm first. Then let me just explain the same algorithm with the example expression. Okay, so we are given infix expression, you can see here, and we return back the postfix converted one. So stack is used for this because we need to remember the operands and the operator such that the precedence levels are maintained in the stack. We should not lose them. In order to store and remember the precedence levels, the stack is used. So we will initialize top as usual, and we use pointers or the index variables like I and K. I'll tell you, I mean, as we proceed, you will know for what purposes it is used. I, for instance, you can see here to scan through the infix expression from the starting character to the end, similar to the evaluation of postfix as we have seen already. Okay, now this is what I told earlier, that we deliberately store a left parenthesis into the stack top. That means we start with the stack with a left parenthesis only. Okay, that means even if the input is an unparenthesized expression like A plus B, we start with left parenthesis. So that's what it means. Why? Because of the algorithm, right? Okay, so now I'll get the first character. You can see here I is the index variable in order to index the character starting from beginning to end in this array called infix. Okay. So X is the character. K is an index which is used in order to keep track of the characters being pushed into the postfix expression. This is the output. So for scanning through the input infix, we use I. In order to store the converted one into the postfix, we use K. Okay. So both are starting from zero. Now we have a case statement here. Depending upon this character, the red, it could be an operand or it could be an operator. That's the possibility. Or it could be a left parenthesis or right parenthesis. So these are the other two possibilities. So any valid infix expression can have either operand or operator or left parenthesis or right parenthesis, nothing else. Okay. Okay. Now, the switch statement or the case statement has this. So it's very simple kind of an algorithm where whenever the incoming precedence, that means x in this case, is 8. So what is 8? You can see here, it is an operator. That's what I said earlier. The moment I get to know that it is an operand A to Z, I simply, you know, push that, in the sense I don't store it in the stack, actually. I send that character to the postfix. So X is put directly into the postfix pointed by K. K is initially 0. So if I have A, it will simply be put into the output expression. Now I increment K because I have already pushed one, added one character to the postfix. Right. On the other hand, supposing if the incoming character or the symbol X is not an operand, it could be a right parenthesis. So when it is a right parenthesis, remember, left parenthesis, we never store it. You can see here, stack precedence is not there. And incoming precedence, of course, is 7, right? I'll come to that. Okay, so now what happens? I pick this, supposing if it is right parenthesis, I need to pop until I get left parenthesis, because that's the matching one. Because supposing if I get right parenthesis, I would have already stored or pushed items into the stack. So I simply pop all of them. That is the converted one which I want, and put it back into my postfix. So remember this, so that when we go through the example, you will understand. So whenever it is right parenthesis, I simply pop until I get my left parenthesis. So until my top of the stack is left parenthesis, keep popping, you can see here, and send it to the postfix. So we don't know how many characters is there until which the left parenthesis may be there. So we need a while loop for that. So keep doing it. Even if you have one, it doesn't matter. So this, all the characters until the left parenthesis is reached in the stack will be popped and put into the output expression postfix. Okay. Now, next, we have the other kinds of symbols. Okay, now there are two more statements to be executed under this closing parenthesis. Remember, the moment you encounter left parenthesis, you are popping and then pushing, putting it into the postfix. But left parenthesis should not stay in the stack, because we already completed for one matching right parenthesis. So we try to execute this, which is pop, that is deleting left parenthesis. And supposing if there are no contents in the stack, there's no point, that means you have done all the conversion process, so you can return. So that is the statements to be executed under when a character encountered in the infix expression as a right parenthesis. For all the rest, for example, it could be an operator or it could be a left parenthesis. Now we come to the default case. So what is default case? We need to push it into the, push it into the stack. You can see here, because we do this first and then push it, provided depending upon the precedence. This is most important one. Okay, so whenever I get the incoming symbol or the character, either the operator or the left parenthesis, depending upon this, this is where we compare the incoming precedence of X and the stack precedence. You can see here, it is a stack precedence. That means the symbol which is there on the top of the stack. So incoming versus the symbol present in the top of the stack. So we will come to know that this, supposing if this precedence is less than this, then you pop. That means you can send it to the output. So what exactly it means? Incoming is less than, you can see here, if it is less than the stack precedence, you can actually send it. Okay, so that will take care of making the postfix expression with the operator where the precedence is the highest first and then the lowest next. That means the order of the precedence is maintained within the postfix expression. So in order to make sure that we use this while loop, I think you will understand better when we take up the example. So we keep popping. Of course, we need to increment k because we are adding characters into the postfix expression. So once you have, you know, false in this condition, then we try to do this statement execution, which is push. So essentially, this may not happen for this while loop, but we will try to push because stack should have some elements or characters or symbols. So it will happen after some time depending upon the precedence. So we pick, this is where we don't need to actually scan through the entire expression full, but we remember these by putting them into the, okay, so the precedence is automatically available in the stack. So after this, you know, the case statement, we actually increment for the while loop next character. So depending upon the character, whether it is an operand, if so, send it to the output directly. If it is a right parenthesis, pop until you get left parenthesis. Otherwise, you can push it. But before that, you try to pop out all these depending upon the incoming and the stack precedence. Go to the next and keep doing this until you finish all the character scanning. So after this while loop is completed, postfix will have the, I mean, this variable will have the postfix expression. So we will now try to understand this algorithm by picking up an example. First one without parenthesis, the simplest one. So A plus B star C, we know the output, you know, expected output, that is ABC star plus. Well, now I have shown here the stack contents and the output, because that's exactly what we have the variables in the algorithm. So the incoming symbol, see this first row indicates that the initial condition of the stack. We have already said that stack top, you know, initially the stack will hold left parent, that's the thing. And there is nothing, output is the initial condition. Okay, what is the first character read? A. So whenever it is an operand, so first it is checked with its precedence value. So ICP of A is actually 8. ICP, this one, you know, incoming precedence value is 8. And directly, you know, we don't push that into the stack. As per the algorithm, since it is yes, the same, I mean, the character is put into the postfix. So you can see here, it has gone to the postfix. Stack contents remains as it is. Next one is plus. See here, it is plus, right? Okay. When it is plus, what we should do? When it is plus, this is not operand, this is not right parenthesis, default, it is plus. So what is the incoming precedence of x? So x in this case is plus, remember that. So what is the precedence of plus? It's 1. Okay, so this is 1. I think I've shown here. Okay, so this is the incoming precedence of plus is 1. And what is the stack precedence? What we have already in the stack is actually top of the stack, sorry, it is left parenthesis. What is the left parenthesis stack precedence? 0, right? So it is 0. Since the condition here, so when do we actually pop? Only when it is less. But in this case, the incoming precedence of A is greater than the stack. That's the reason why we deliberately make the precedence values like this so that we push it. Okay, so this condition is false, while loop is not executed and it comes to push. That means I am supposed to push this operator into the stack. So the concept of this algorithm is operands are sent to the output directly, whereas the operators are saved in the stack. Okay, so plus goes here, B directly it goes, no issue. Star, we need to check what is the precedence of star compared to top of the stack. So obviously it is more, star has got a higher precedence than this, so I'm forced to push that in the stack as per the algorithm. Now you can see here in the stack, the order of, you know, precedence is already built from top to bottom. So this is my top, this is my bottom. So top of the stack actually has got higher precedent values, right? So that's why we have fixed the precedences like this. Okay, now I'm saving. Now C has to be pushed directly to the output. So C, now what happens? I assume that I'm adding one extra right parenthesis, though the input doesn't have. So incoming symbol, we assume that there is a closing because I started with left stack content. So I need a closing parenthesis. So this closing parenthesis, once if it comes as an incoming, what happens? Okay, so closing, you can see here is the closing parenthesis. So as long as top of the stack is not equal to left parenthesis, so pop and then put it. So closing parenthesis has got until this, you have to pop, right? You can see here pop, pop. So I simply star, put it in the output, plus put in the output. And when it comes to left parenthesis, I stop it because there's a closing parenthesis and delete. So I think we have got already the output very easily that it is shown as the infix is converted into postfix. Now, supposing if you have a parenthesis, there is without parenthesis, this is with parenthesis. You can see here we start with the stack with the left parenthesis. And this is the actual parenthesis. We start scanning from here. So incoming symbol is left parenthesis because of, you know, the default case, this one left parenthesis. This is false and hence we push into the stack. You can see here it's greater and hence we put it into the stack. So remember, left parenthesis, when it is encountered in the infix expression, it will be saved in the stack because we look for an equivalent right parenthesis, that is here, and we can get this. So that's the advantage. So now the next character is A. A will go directly here, plus will be saved in the stack. B directly it will go, you can see here, right parenthesis. So when we get the right parenthesis, try to pop until you get a left parenthesis. So what we do is plus is popped, and here left parenthesis, matching is formed and it has been deleted and only one left parenthesis is kept. The incoming next one is star, so it's saved in the stack, and C, it's pushed directly here output, and final right parenthesis, our right parenthesis, then you pop that also, whatever is there in the stack until you get left, so you can see here. So that means A plus B within the bracket, hence it is done first, AB plus, you can see, and then C star, done. So that's exactly what the algorithm does. So you can go through a bigger example here. A very complicated expression is given, the same process. You can see here the stack will consist of only the operators and the left parenthesis. And the output directly, I mean, whenever operand comes, it's just sent to the output. So end of the execution of this algorithm, you will see that the order is maintained, I mean precedence order is maintained. So we'll continue in the next session. Thanks for watching, and come back for my next session. Thank you. Okay, now there are two more statements to be executed under this closing parenthesis. Remember, the moment you encounter left parenthesis, you are popping and then pushing, I mean, putting it into the postfix. But left parenthesis should not stay in the stack because we already completed for one matching right parenthesis. So we try to execute this, which is pop, that is deleting left parenthesis. And supposing if there are no contents in the stack, there's no point. That means you have done all the conversion process, so you can return. So that is the statements to be executed under when a character encountered in the infix expression as a right parenthesis. For all the rest, for example, it could be an operator or it could be a left parenthesis. Now we come to the default case. So what is default case? We need to push it into the push it into the stack. You can see here, because we do this first and then push it, provided depending upon the precedence. This is most important one. Okay, so whenever I get the incoming symbol or the character, either the operator or the left parenthesis, depending upon this, this is where we compare the incoming precedence of X and the stack precedence. You can see here it is a stack precedence. That means the symbol which is there on the top of the stack. So incoming versus the symbol present in the top of the stack. So we will come to know that this, supposing if this precedence is less than this, then you pop. That means you can send it to the output. So what exactly it means? Incoming is less than, you can see here, if it is less than the stack precedence, you can actually send it. Okay, so that will take care of making the postfix expression with the operator where the precedence is the highest first and then the lowest next. That means the order of the precedence is maintained within the postfix expression. So in order to make sure that, we use this while loop. I think you will understand better when we take up the example. So we keep popping. Of course, we need to increment k because we are adding characters into the postfix expression. So once you have, you know, false in this condition, then we try to do this statement execution, which is push. So essentially, this may not happen for this while loop, but we will try to push because stack should have some elements or characters or symbols. So it will happen after some time depending upon the precedence. So we pick, this is where we don't need to actually scan through the entire expression full, but we remember these by putting them into the, okay? So the precedence is automatically available in the stack. So after this, you know, the case statement, we actually increment for the while loop next character. So depending upon the character, whether it is an operand, if so, send it to the output directly. If it is a right parenthesis, pop until you get left parenthesis. Otherwise, you can push it. But before that, you try to pop out all these depending upon the incoming and the stack precedence. Go to the next and keep doing this until you finish all the character scanning. So after this while loop is completed, postfix will have the, I mean, this variable will have the postfix expression. So we will now try to understand this algorithm by picking up an example. First one without parenthesis, the simplest one. So A plus B star C, we know the output, you know, expected output, that is ABC star plus. Well, now I have shown here the stack contents and the output, because that's exactly what we have the variables in the algorithm. So the incoming symbol, see this first row indicates that the initial condition of the stack. We have already said that stack top, you know, initially the stack will hold left parenthesis, that's the thing. And there is nothing output, this is the initial condition. Okay, what is the first character read? A. So whenever it is an operand, so first it is checked with its precedence value. So ICP of A is actually 8. ICP, this one, you know, incoming president's value is 8. And directly, you know, we don't push that into the stack. As per the algorithm, since it is yes, the same, I mean, the character is put into the postfix. So you can see here, it has gone to the postfix. Stack contents remains as it is. Next one is plus. See here, it is plus, right? Okay. When it is plus, what we should do? When it is plus, this is not operand, this is not right parenthesis, default, it is plus. So what is the incoming precedence of x? So x in this case is plus, remember that. So what is the precedence of plus? It's 1. Okay, so this is 1. I think I've shown here. Okay, so this is the incoming precedence of plus is 1. And what is the stack precedence? What we have already in the stack is actually top of the stack, sorry. It is left parenthesis. What is the left parenthesis stack precedence? 0. Right? So it is 0. Since the condition here, so when do we actually pop? Only when it is less. But in this case, the incoming precedence of A is greater than the stack. That's the reason why we deliberately make the precedence values like this so that we push it. Okay. So this condition is false. The while loop is not executed and it comes to push. That means I am supposed to push this operator into the stack. So the concept of this algorithm is operands are sent to the output directly, whereas the operators are saved in the stack. Okay, so plus goes here. B, directly it goes, no issue. Star, we need to check. What is the precedence of star compared to top of the stack? So obviously it is more, star has got a higher precedence than this. So I'm forced to push that in the stack as per the algorithm. Now you can see here in the stack, the order of, you know, precedence is already built from top to bottom. So this is my top, this is my bottom. So top of the stack actually has got higher precedent values, right? So that's why we have fixed the precedences like this. Okay, now I'm saving. Now C has to be pushed directly to the output. So C, now what happens? I assume that I'm adding one extra right parenthesis, though the input doesn't have. So incoming symbol, we assume that there is a closing because I started with left stack content. So I need a closing parenthesis. So this closing parenthesis, once if it comes as an incoming, what happens? Okay, so closing, you can see here is the closing parenthesis. So as long as top of the stack is not equal to left parenthesis. So pop and then put it. So closing parenthesis has got until this, you have to pop, right? You can see here pop, pop. So I simply star, put it in the output, plus put it in the output. And when it comes to left parenthesis, I stop it because there's a closing parenthesis and delete. So I think we have got already the output very easily that it is shown as the infix is converted into postfix. Now, supposing if you have a parenthesis, that is without parenthesis, this is with parenthesis. You can see here we start with the stack with the left parenthesis and this is the actual parenthesis. We start scanning from here. So incoming symbol is left parenthesis because of, you know, the default case, this one, left parenthesis. This is false and hence we push into the stack. You can see here it's greater and hence we put it into the stack. So remember, left parenthesis, when it is encountered in the infix expression, it will be saved in the stack because we look for an equivalent right parenthesis that is here and we can get this. So that's the advantage. So now the next character is A. A will go directly here. Plus will be saved in the stack. B directly it will go, you can see here. right parenthesis. So when we get the right parenthesis, try to pop until you get a left parenthesis. So what we do is plus is popped, and here left parenthesis matching is formed, and it has been deleted, and only one left parenthesis is kept. The incoming next one is star, so it's saved in the stack, and C, it's pushed directly here output, and final right parenthesis, our right parenthesis, then you pop that also, whatever is there in the stack until you get left, so you can see here. So that means A plus B within the bracket, hence it is done first, AB plus, you can see, and then C star, done. So that's exactly what the algorithm does. So you can go through a bigger example here. A very complicated expression is given. The same process. You can see here the stack will consist of only the operators and the left parenthesis. And the output directly, I mean, whenever operand comes, it's just sent to the output. So end of the execution of this algorithm, you will see that the order is maintained. I mean, precedence order is maintained. So we'll continue in the next session. Thanks for watching, and come back for my next session. Thank you.